Content warning. This episode is all about a far-right extremist, so if you're sensitive to discussions about violence or hate speech, this might be a difficult watch for you. Fascists, the worst guys. We talk about them a lot on the left, but we tend to paint with a pretty broad brush. We like to think of fascists as all thinking the same, behaving the same, or more or less being simple to recognize. It's ironic, however, given the fascist tendency to despise diversity, that there's a wide-ranging diversity of thought among different fascist groups. If we expect all fascists to act alike, that allows fascists that act differently to operate unnoticed. Welcome to Know Your Fash, where we take a closer look at a specific fascist or group of fascists to see what makes them goose-step. It's my hope that by shining a light on these creeps, we can understand how they think and operate a little better so that we're more equipped to fight them and anyone else they inspire. To put it simply, fascism is authoritarian and xenophobic paleo-ultranationalism. That's a lot of $5 words, so to explain, a fascist believes the following. Their national, ethnic, or religious group is superior to all others. At one point, their national, ethnic, or religious group was at the height of its power and now is in decline, due to the corrupting, degenerative influence of outsiders. Therefore, in order to regain that power, they must return to the old ways. And finally, the world is a stage of perpetual conflict in which the strong destroy the weak. Therefore, strong and usually dictatorial leadership is needed to return society to its full glory. Today we'll be discussing Nick Fuentes, a far-right streamer and provocateur. He runs a daily stream called America First, and up until relatively recently, was among the most popular and profitable streamers on the DLive streaming platform, where he had to retreat after he was banned from almost every other streaming platform. He is a key figurehead of the Groyper movement, a loosely defined collection of far-right weirdos who identify themselves with this particular internet bullshit. Internet bullshit is very central to Fuentes's brand. His particular shtick couldn't work anywhere else. His rhetoric is so thoroughly saturated with semi-ironic, perpetually online, nihilistic nonsense that it's virtually impenetrable to anyone but the shittiest of shitposters. Listening to the contents of Fuentes' speech might lead one to think he is completely inconsistent, constantly contradicting himself and backpedaling every statement he makes until you're not sure what, if anything, he believes. But you knowing the particulars of what he believes is irrelevant to Fuentes' goals, which are pretty simple. To mainstream discussions of taboo topics such as white nationalism, Holocaust denial, queer phobia, and of course, fascism. To introduce them back into the conversation, even if just to refute them. And on some level, this video and videos like it are playing into his hands. His enormous, disproportionate hands. Whoa. But it's such a common strategy, the far right, that he warrants discussion either way. They do this a lot. They introduce talking points by way of convincing other people to refute them, thus giving those talking points airtime and the appearance of being just another idea in the ever-expanding marketplace of ideas. After all, we're just asking questions. For his part, Fuentes prefers to refer to himself as a campus conservative.
I say this as a campus conservative. I say this, we have to affirm, we believe in total equality. We do not endorse Nazism or white nationalism or white separatism or anything like that. We are merely campus conservatives who want to see every race, every group protected under the law. That's what we want to see.
I couldn't really tell you what that means because he's not in college anymore. Maybe he was when he recorded this. I don't think he was because as near as I can tell, he didn't start this program, America First, until leaving Boston University, because he was basically kicked out for attending Unite the Right. I'd love to confirm that, but it's very hard to find the first episode of America First because it's no longer on YouTube or anywhere else you might find normal content. The earliest episode I can find is number 52 from November of 2017, and he seems to upload every weekday, so that timeline adds up. What I'm saying is, it's hard to get concrete information on this guy because most of his content ends up getting removed for hate speech. Either way, while he refers to himself as a campus conservative, it's pretty clear if you pay attention to what he says that his sympathies lie way farther right than just a normal conservative. Here he is saying he'd gladly march with Mussolini or Francisco Franco if they were alive today.
I don't know, man. If Antifa were marching down the streets and they were waving the banner of Benito Mussolini or Francisco Franco, I'd be joining them. Frankly, if Antifa was waving the banner of phalangism, if they were waving the banner of Franco, and they were saying, you know, Catholic fascism now, I would join them. I would become a part of Antifa.
So he certainly supports everything a fascist might support. He basically just said so. But he's hesitant to call himself a fascist, and here's him explaining why.
Why can you not be a white nationalist in 2019 today? Why can you not talk about white identity politics? Why can you not be authentically right-wing and reactionary? Why can you not identify as a fascist? Why can't you do these things in 2019? So what is it specifically? Gee, what is it specifically about this guy? What is it specifically about the Nazis? They didn't just do mass murder. They weren't just totalitarian. They weren't just fascist. They weren't just right-wing. There was a very specific group that they went after. It was a very specific event that happened. It's something that's illegal to question in like 13 or 19 or 20 different countries in Europe. And maybe we really have to start asking ourselves, what's going on there? What's going on there?
According to a write-up in Right Wing Watch, although he agrees with white nationalism, he's hesitant to refer to himself as a white nationalist as well. Quote, "The reason I wouldn't call myself a white nationalist, it's not because I don't see the necessity for white people to have a homeland and for white people to have a country," Fuentes said. "It's because I think that that kind of terminology is used almost exclusively by the left to defame. And I think the terminology and the labels that we use, I don't think that we can look at them outside of the context of their connotations in America." End quote. This is a recurring pattern in Fuentes' rhetoric. His strategy is the careful management of optics. He's always extremely careful to, on paper, never actually say what he means, and to throw in little caveats that absolve him of any culpability if anyone acts on his provocations. He'll say he disapproves of violence of any kind. But then in the same breath, he'll say that all legitimate options for dealing with his enemies have been expended. So, what else can people be expected to do? He'll say he believes that the Holocaust happened.
And, the Holocaust happened, of course, we know that. And the mass shootings have all happened. I mean, I believe everything the government says.
But then go on to imply that he's only saying that so the government won't kill him.
We are not dangerous, all right? We are totally within the system. Don't kill me, don't.
So hopefully you see the game being played here. If anyone calls him out on his rants about how there has to be some reason why you're not allowed to question the Holocaust, he can point to the part of the speech where he says explicitly that he believes the Holocaust happened. How can they call him a Holocaust denier? He said it happened. Why, it's slander to imply he's a Holocaust denier. But his far-right buddies get the message, because these statements are always couched in the language of having to explain them to his powerful enemies. People who want to kill, or perhaps more realistically, silence him. Which sends the message loud and clear, hey, I have to say this to cover my ass, but you know I don't believe it, right? Likewise, if anyone calls him out for his repeated calls for violence against elected officials, he can say, hey, I said I don't condone violence. However, you can clearly see how he behaves when he thinks there'll be no consequences. Fuentes was present at the storming of the U.S. Capitol building on January 6th, and while he didn't enter the building himself, according to a write-up from the Southern Poverty Law Center, Fuentes said in a speech to the insurrectionists, "Keep moving towards the Capitol. It appears we are taking the Capitol back. Break down the barriers and disregard the police. The Capitol belongs to us." A few days later, Fuentes had this to say on his stream about the events of January 6th. "I'm not advocating violence or, you know, people killing or anything else like that. I'm not advocating for a revolution or an insurrection because that would be illegal. And also because we're not there yet. You know, as evidenced by yesterday." Pay close attention to his phrasing there. "I'm not advocating violence, people killing, revolution, or insurrection because it is illegal. Because we're not there yet." Again, if a journalist or the cops or whoever were to accuse Fuentes of advocating violence, he can point to the part of the speech where he says he doesn't. But you know, on a practical basis, because it's illegal and we don't want to get in trouble and we're not ready for the violence I definitely do not condone, wink. Make no mistake, Fuentes' goal, even if he's cagey about saying it out loud, is a white nationalist revolution. He wants to foment a return to segregation, to stop all immigration to the United States, to criminalize abortion and homosexuality, and just generally turn the United States into some kind of tradcath autocracy. Guess I have to explain what a tradcath is. Tradcaths, or traditional Catholics, are utter fucking dorks who believe that the Catholic Church lost legitimacy because of, or at the very least, made a mistake with, Vatican II, a set of proclamations by the Vatican in the 60s intended to bring the Church's dogma in line with modern values. They instituted such unforgivable reforms as speaking languages other than ecclesiastical Latin during Mass, admitting Protestants were Christian and also not their enemies, and most heinously, of course, admitting that the Jewish people do not personally bear responsibility for the murder of Christ. I guess I should also point out that Fuentes is partially of Mexican descent, and I don't know how he squares that with his anti-immigration beliefs, particularly when it seems they definitely extend to Mexicans, according to the Washington Post. In a video after the August shootings in El Paso that left 22 dead, including Mexicans and Mexican-Americans, Fuentes declared, "The easiest way for Mexicans to not get shot and killed in Walmart is for them to not fucking be here." I assume it says fucking. The Washington Post censored it. I assume fucking was the expletive used. Fuentes says that he wants to return to a sort of muscular right position, where the far right advocates for what it wants directly, rather than couching it in terms of what is acceptable to the mainstream right. For example, on the subject of immigration,
"Why can we not be in favor of, you know, immigration, or rather being against immigration in itself? You know, why is that we have to make economic arguments against immigration and not demographic arguments against immigration? Well, because it really all goes back to these negative connotations. And why can we not be muscularly right-wing on social issues?"
He's also not really shy about who he thinks represents a muscular right-wing type of figure. Guess who it is? Guess. Go ahead and guess, of course. It's our old pal, Adolf Hitler.
You know, you might hear a question like, why is it not okay to be a fascist? And you would say, well, of course, because fascism is wrong. You know, fascism is authoritarian or something like this. But it's okay to be a communist in 2019. So understand where I'm coming from. It's okay to say you're a socialist. It's okay to say you're a communist. It's okay to wear a Che Guevara t-shirt. It's okay to wear a hammer and sickle. So when I say, why is it not okay to be a fascist, I mean this in the sense that it's okay to be many other strains of extremist ideology. Perfectly acceptable and permissible. And it, by the way, it has nothing to do with death count either, right? We know that Mao Zedong killed 70 million people. I could wear a Mao Zedong t-shirt in public and not worry about getting killed. Could I wear a swastika t-shirt in public? No.
You see, everybody, the reason that people consider the Holocaust as somehow unique in terms of mass murder or one of the worst events in history is because powerful forces control the media and government. Pretty weird that you can identify as one of these other extremist ideologies, but not as a fascist. Now, I'm not a fascist. It just seems really weird that the Nazis are singled out like that, doesn't it? And to address this talking point in the plainest terms possible, self-identifying as a Nazi demonstrates an intent to commit exterminationist violence in a way that other extremist ideologies do not. Fuentes kind of glosses over this very obvious point that the stated intent of Nazis is to exterminate the Jewish people, because it doesn't fit into the narrative of Nazism being somehow sort of unfairly maligned position suppressed by the dastardly Jews who control the American government, media, and education system. Now, if I believed that mass murder were inherent to communism or socialism or whatever, I don't, because I'm not a complete head-ass dipshit, I wouldn't then argue, well, it's unfair that they get to argue for mass murder and we don't. My argument would be more along the lines of, hey, don't you think those guys shouldn't be advocating mass murder? That seems like a problem for me, a person who enjoys living. Furthermore, any self-described communist, socialist, or anarchist who starts arguing for the mass extermination of a religious, ethnic, or national minority is just as much my enemy and the enemy of any other socialist, communist, or anarchist as Nick Fuentes is. You'll notice, though, for some reason, those ideologies don't tend to attract as many fans of literal exterminationist genocide. In fact, much of their squabbling comes down to accusing other groups of genocide, because among those groups, and indeed most non-Nazi groups, it is taken for granted that genocide is self-evidently evil. Weird, isn't it? I wonder if that has anything to do with each group's public perception. Fuentes believes that the state should be used to force society to conform to his moral standards.
The law is the instructor. The law must come in. You know, enough of this libertarian, individualist, constitutional crap. We need the state to go in there and force the society to be the way we want it to be.
And since, as we've discussed, he stated that he and his compatriots are not yet ready for revolution, it's not difficult to put two and two together on how the state would behave after the revolution he imagines. Abortion would be illegal, and doctors who perform it would be jailed, and so would women who receive them.
If doctors are facing 100 years in jail if they perform an abortion, they're going to think twice about performing an abortion. And you know what? If a woman was facing 100 years, if she got an abortion, outside of a doctor, she would also think twice about getting an abortion. That's how these things work.
Race mixing would, of course, be illegal.
Would you say that me having sex with my dog is the same thing as me having sex with a black man?
No. But they would both be degenerate.
Oh! This.
Against interracial relationships.
Yeah, I don't think it's something that should be promoted. I don't think it's...
Okay, all right. Let's go ahead. Let's just go on to the next topic.
I agree.
I like the laughing. Yeah. That'll be really funny when you guys are bred out of existence.
Homosexuality, transgenderism, and the promotion thereof, i.e. any public advocacy for the rights of queer people, would be illegal.
We can at once say that we oppose homosexuality. We oppose people that promote it. I don't think Milo promotes it, by the way, which is a good thing. We're not saying we're against everybody. We're simply saying if you're out there saying there's nothing wrong with it, it's fine, pushing it on kids, the normalization, you know, and not acknowledging the connection between that and other deviancy, pedophilia, disease, all the rest, that kind of rhetoric must be condemned.
Pornography and drugs would be illegal.
If that doesn't happen, they're going to go to the therapist and get prescribed Ritalin and destroy their brain and turn them into a school shooter or something. If that doesn't happen, their friends will introduce them to some kind of drug. If that doesn't happen, you can be sure, it's guaranteed, that their mind will be destroyed by social media or video games or pornography. That much is virtually a guarantee. It's so ubiquitous at this point.
All immigration would be ceased in order to preserve the racial demographics of the United States.
I say this all the time, but I don't get it. How do people believe that we could take shitty people and bring them into a great country and the great country gets better? How does that work, right?
All liberal lawmakers and insufficiently fascist conservative lawmakers would be killed, which means just about everybody who works in the government would be killed.
What can you and I do to a state legislator besides kill him? Although we should not do that. I'm not advising that, but I mean, what else can you do, right?
He'd also have civil liberties stripped away from groups he doesn't like. He's claimed in the past that the First Amendment doesn't apply to Muslims and immigrants, which is a fair reading of the amendment as long as you don't look at the words it contains, because those say the literal opposite of that. Other than that, though, you know, fair dues. And all of that is just the stuff he'll admit to out loud. And keep in mind that this guy is obsessed with optics and making sure he can pretend to be a run-of-the-mill conservative. Given his abiding hatred for Jewish people and the conspiracies he pushes around them and his apologetics for the Nazis, I don't think it's uncharitable to assume he'd also be in favor of some sort of state violence against Jewish people. And if all of that sounds like an impossibly harsh, cruel, and miserable way to live, you have to also understand that Fuentes does not see himself as being subject to the rules he wishes to enforce on the rest of society. Race mixing is, of course, degenerate and wrong, but he's keen to point out that he himself is of mixed race. Homosexuality is degenerate, and it means you're not a real Christian, and you will go to hell, but hey, jerk into transgender porn if women aren't fucking you.
Are gay? Yeah, are gay. I've always maintained are gay, of course. You have sex with a man, it's gay. There's no getting around that. Now, that said, it's, you know, we're in times where women are not really meeting their obligations. So I'm not saying you're not... Look, if you have sex with a you're gay.
And there's also the matter of his ironic love of catboys. He had a channel in his Discord dedicated to catboys. He had a questionably sexual relationship with a streamer named Catboy Kami, or as he was known at the time, Loli Socks, referring to Lolicon, type of hentai for... pedophiles.
I did a stream with Lolly Socks. He's now known as Catboy Cammy. He changed his name. I advise him to change his name because, you know, Lolly Socks, not great optics. You know, the streamer in question, Lolly Socks, Catboy Cammy, is not a homosexual. You know, that's just not true. So if anybody can find any evidence to the contrary on any of these points, feel free to share it. But, you know, for the most part, it's been a lot of lies.
Yeah, for real? This guy? There's no evidence this guy's gay. This guy? Nothing. Nothing gay about this guy. Straight as an arrow, obviously. And he's a great role model. Based on his blatant hypocrisy, you might think Fuentes is just an opportunistic grifter. Someone who saw the writing on the wall and knew he could make a quick buck. And there's definitely an element of that for sure. It's unclear to me the degree to which he believes what he's saying, and the degree to which he says things for ideological reasons or for personal gain. Who knows? But one thing is clear. Fuentes wants to remove the taboo around discussing horrible and dangerous ideas like fascism, anti-Semitism, white nationalism, and all sorts of other hateful, destructive objectives. He wants to present himself as a normal, albeit controversial, conservative who's just asking questions. And every time he is platformed by some Republican rube like Michelle Malkin, he's one step closer to being able to sway the public perception of fascism towards legitimacy. People sometimes ask why I spend time talking about fascists at all, aren't I just giving them attention? And Fuentes is a perfect example of why. If people aren't reminded who he is and what exactly he stands for, he becomes just another voice in the crowd, some nondescript talking head in a suit. But he's not. He's a dangerous ideologue, and if he and people like him are allowed to weasel their way into the mainstream, it presents a very credible threat to you and the people you love. And just for the record, if you're a conservative, know that he's not going to stop at just the leftists, or the BLM activists, or the Democrats, or the feminists, or whoever else you think, low-key, kind of deserves to get got. You are an ally of convenience for him and others like him. He wants to see you dead as much as he wants to see me dead. So you better hope he doesn't get us, because if he does, you're next. Kind of a heavy one this week, sorry about that. As usual on this series, I will not be eyeballing anyone. I don't want to inadvertently subject someone to reprisal from fascists. The proceeds from this video for the first month are going to be donated to charity. I don't want to make any money off of Nick Fuentes. I don't know what charity yet, but it will be listed in the description. So go down there and check. And whichever charity it is, it's probably worth giving a donation to as well. The reason I say for the first month is because there's no option on YouTube to just set that video to give the money to charity automatically. So the first month is where it makes most of the money anyway. I'm not going to keep checking the video for the rest of my life. I'll just demonetize it after a month. Anyway, that's all. Thanks.